Okay, next is a discussion of establishing a study group and feasibility of turning over the jurisdiction of the New Orleans Interior Drainage Canal to the Sewerage and Water Board. We've had some members of the public today address that specifically.
Right, and that's another issue that I brought to the table. I think that that these canals and their attenuant levees need to be removed from the federal system, even if it's not removed from our authority. These canals feature very strongly in the water plan that we were just talking about, that Wagon Associates developed for the city of New Orleans. I have a copy of it on CD here that I can provide for our staff. They, in their plan, do a lot of things with these canals, and they do a lot of things which initially seem to be very well founded. They first of all, they lower the heights of the levees because it's not necessary for those. Matter of fact, they remove the flood walls. They lower the heights because it's not necessary to be there because the storm surge no longer will be allowed to come up in the canals. Then they also shrink the footprint in many cases. They shrink the footprint of the berms that are going to be required to remain in place as it slowly transitions from option one, which everybody protested greatly, but we got anyway, and begins to work towards option two, which is more, which is much more friendly to the surrounding community, and I think probably better for the city of New Orleans. But I would urge that we try to get it away from the federal system, first of all, and so we don't have core interference. Because one thing I've noticed about the Corps of Engineers, when it comes to changes or hydraulic studies or new ideas, they have the, let's say, they seem to have they were about as nimble as an elephant on value. They're just not able to accept these changes very well. And so I would like to have them out of the process to where it's the citizens of New Orleans, where it's their agencies, the Sewage and Water Board. Perhaps we'll keep the levees. I don't know what the wisest decision is in that regard, but I do know that we have to really look at it. And I know that the city of New Orleans has a lot of plans for these canals. And so I would urge that we establish some sort of study group or perhaps task one of our IDIQ consultants to come up with what we're going to have to do to get this out of the federal system. Might take an act of Congress. Well, fine. That doesn't scare me off. But we've got to do something because I just don't believe it should continue as it is.
Okay. That was brought up by the Operations Committee, and that there's a boatload of issues that must be considered. And knowing that came out as the Operations Committee, and you and I spoke just before the meeting, I contacted a number of people to see if they would be willing to work on such an ad hoc committee. And so I'm going to name an ad hoc committee that will take a look at it. These will include Sewerage Water Board Executive Director, the General Superintendent of the Sewerage Water Board, the District Commander of the Corps of Engineers. I know you don't think that they're a necessary part, but I mean, the outfall counts currently are in the federal system, so I do think that there need to be at least a participant in this. The Regional Director of the Authority, the President of the Authority, the Jefferson Parish Office of Public Works, and the CPRA Chairman. I think with that high-level group, they should be able to break down a bunch of barriers, Steve. So that's the committee, and although I haven't spoken to Cosby, I need to talk to Cosby about that. So anyway, that is a committee that's set up to look at the outfall canals, the issue of turning over the outfall canal flood walls and levees to Sewerage and Water Board. All right, next, we